It was all a dream on the scene, making mean.
Then I came along and changed everything.
From ciphers to diapers.
Green jiggly things.
But the grind don't stop.
We just got a bigger team.
All the way to the top.
Mom, what does that mean?
The time is now or never. We are dream team.
I was gonna get paid for this.
What's up, guys? It's your girl, Lyric Kane, aka Nene, aka whatever it is that you want to call me, back with yet another reaction video. As requested in the comment section underneath one of my other videos, today I will be reacting to Little Dicky Truman. This is the full version, so yeah, you already know the original video link will be in the description box down below, as well as, get that out your mouth, as well as all of my social media links. Make sure that you follow us on IG, best friends since birth. Also, check out my music page on IG, Lyric Kane Official. Also, in the description box down below, you'll be able to find my other YouTube channel. Make sure that you head over there and check out my music. If you like what you hear, then go ahead and give the video a thumbs up, subscribe, and turn on notifications so that you don't miss out on all of my latest music videos, original songs, cover songs, remakes, remixes, challenges, and live performances. With that being said, let's see what Dave has for us. Audio, by the way.
I guess y'all on board. Young man couldn't lead that shore. Had the life they made for him till he seeked out more. Boat ride, couldn't see that storm. He'll get up though, he know he close. It's too late to jump ship. Aw, damn, you that motherfucker shit. I know, this shit became a trip, Cabo. I've been the wound, but you can feel it when I kick it. I know, and you too must be rocking with the Dicky Bono. It's like I hit the lotto, I had to hit the Waldo. I couldn't see it for a minute, shit was hitting Waldo. They treat it like I'm going crazy, I'm just playing, I don't. It's just, I know. I saw the world like, hold up. Damn near faking on the side. Let me take you on a ride. Let me tell you about the one that couldn't take the 9 to 5. Used to take the 9 to 5 down to Richmond, bumping jigger up in the ride. Used to think along the drive about my drive. Used to wonder why. Used to wonder when the world will see me like I'm seeing mine. Used to whine. Used to wanna shine. Used to wanna dine. Used to talk to bitches in my mind when they were walking by. Girl, what's happening? Girl, what's happening? I ain't really about to get involved, that's what's happening. Everything I knew was unevolved like a Baptist. Laying on my mattress, praying I could have this. And now when I get Tinder matches, they think they been catfish. Now I be controlling how we living like a fascist. Now I got this weight up off my shoulders like a strapless. Remember this shit was hapless. Remember the day I you the shit, dad. You been killing everything you did. Got the whole world talking all about what you did. Got your old girl talking all about what you is. Got your old world looking like it's his. For the fuck of it. And one of them bitches I've been fucking with been wondering how I could work this much and stomach it. She wonders what I want from it. I said, we don't gotta get into it. She like, nah, just do it. She a psychology student. She always following up. Find a guy to be amusing as fuck. Usually I'll answer her truthfully, but truthfully I'm unusually used to being unusually good at internalizing when music is not provided, but I'll humor ho. Ask her if she ever saw the Truman Show. She like, yeah. I'm like, well, when I saw that shit, I was convinced I was living like Jim. A similar situation where I was the basis of everyone's entertainment, like really up in the basement talking to y'all in the mirror, because I thought that little David was some American hero. I know it's selfish and all, but I just felt it's my call. I was a 10-year-old then, by 2010 I was wrong. I'm like, aw, damn, you the motherfucker though. I know, this shit became a trip, Cabo. I've been the wound, but you can feel it when I kick it. I know, and you too must be rocking with the Dicky Bono. It's like I hit the lotto, I had to hit the Waldo. I couldn't see it for a minute, shit was hitting Waldo. They treat it like I'm going crazy, I'm just playing, I don't. It's just, I know. 23 barged up in my apartment, I am D-bar. Gotta do this shit, I gotta recharge, but I gotta be smart. Moving up that ladder, company star, fuck it, that ain't nothing. I am the star, spitting like a retard. Work was like a prison, I'm just seeing bars. My boss was all up in my camp, but I'm just seeing Lars. I've been a heavyweight Muhammad Ali, and if he can mold that out of clay, then I can turn to Lil D. So now I'm snapping like I'm Truman, but off and on, there's always something in the way. I should be off and gone. Girl, I'm sorry if this dragon, I just need you to imagine being stuck up on the land without a captain. When every day is average, and every day you're feeling like a captive, and feel like something's seriously lacking. And you fear what could happen if you just leave it on the table like napkins. But yo, you really fearing hitting them rapids and leaving everything behind, cause you don't know what that horizon brings. But girl, you gotta know what kind of fish you is. Survival instinct, kick this sink or swim. I flip the playlist, quit my day gig now. I'm on a boat, lonely island, irony. And you still been trying to figure
at how I work this tirelessly. But girl, this is everything I've thought. This for everything I fought. This for who I am to me becomes to y'all. Go. They're telling me no, but I just be telling them yeah. Go. I just be telling them yeah. Go. I just be telling them yeah. Tell them I'm gone. Yeah. I just pretend I ain't scared. Go. Don't even know if it's there. Go. Don't even know if I care. Cause girl, this is Truman approaching the wall. Until I'm me, I am nothing at all. Until I'm free, I will not see beyond. I had to be who I was all along, ayy. I think I might have broke it down. Hopping on the fucking steps like ain't no one round. Open up that door, you bet, shipping going down. Guess the only thing that's left is to take a bow. Oh damn, you that motherfucking shit. I know, this shit became a trip combo. I've been a wound, but you can feel it when I kick it, I know. And you too must be rocking with a Dicky Bono. It's like I hit the lotto, I had to hit the wall though. I couldn't see it for a minute, shit was hitting wall though. They treat it like I'm going crazy, I'm just praying I don't. It's just, I know, it's just, I know. Fuck, that felt good. Well, that's all I got. The show is over as they say. Honestly, I just think that part in the Truman Show where his boat hits the wall is really the exact moment that I'm at in my own life right now. Metaphorically, of course. And I think I'm ready for it. Like, I've been thinking about it. I think I'm ready. I mean, if I'm being completely transparent with y'all, like, my lifestyle hasn't really changed that much, you know, considering where I think I'm at musically. Like, I'm still at the point right now where pretty much any bitch that tweets at me anything remotely flirtatious, I have seen not just one of your pictures, I've seen the entire catalog.
Wow.
That's the type of shit that's going down over here right now, so I am definitely ready for that next step, you know what I'm saying? I think it's close, too. I think it's close, like, Diddy tweeted about me, you know, that I don't know if he handles his own Twitter. I would assume he probably doesn't, actually, but, like, I'm so confident that I feel as though, like, me and Diddy will have a moment just about this outro, like, where we're both sitting next to each other, smoking cigars, and being like, hey, remember when you said that shit on that outro? Like, I'm like, yeah, this is the exact moment I did that for, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Bring the beat back up. I don't know why. Keep, like, loop everything. I want to be talking for minutes, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, shout out my MacBook Pro. Had that shit since 09. I made my first song ever on it. Like, when I called myself Lil Dicky, I made my, like, fucking album songs on that shit. We survived, baby. Shout out Allen Iverson, Larry David, Will Smith, and Kobe Bryant for making me the man that I am today, both on and off the court. Shout out my mother. What a great woman. She's so mad that I recorded these conversations. She honestly went crazy. It took so much convincing to allow this. But she's awesome. She's adapting to the rap game, as we all are. Look, I just want to get this to a place where I can sell TMZ pictures of my actual asshole.
Wow.
You know? Because I think that'd be such a feat if I could actually create, like, an alt alias and sell TMZ pictures of my own asshole. Like, profit off of that. That I would totally do it. I don't know why Seth Rogen's not already doing it. And I'm seeing the signs that it's not, that I think I'm seeing the signs. I hope I am. If I'm really just misreading all these signs, then I am 100% gonna have, like, a legitimate nervous breakdown at some point very soon. So we'll find out about that. But I see some signs, like I really am not fucking that much. But, like, the other day I did fuck a bitch to music. Like, I fucked a bitch to some Miguel. And that's kind of new for me, if I'm being real. Like, I had never actually done it before. But I was feeling like on some king shit, you know what I'm saying? So I was like, man, I'm gonna fuck this bitch to some Miguel right now. Actually, to be completely real with you, I will never fuck a girl to music again. I found the whole thing to feel, like, completely cliche. Like, I don't need my emotions dictated to me by, like, music. It makes me feel like I'm in, like, a TV scene. It takes all the, like, realness out of the moment for me. Like, I actually was actually super weirded out by it. So, but still, like, I am about to let my hair down, and I don't know, I just feel like it's all coming. I feel like I'm literally, like, about to find out about everything. And it's exciting. And, I had pink eye last week, and I remember thinking, as I, like, was, like, real down, because I was, like, trying to keep recording and shit, but I was thinking, like, what would Michael Jordan do? And he would play through the pink eye.
Not so what would Jesus do?
I'm still not fully recovered, you know what I'm saying? I'm definitely clearing up, like, it's totally on the upswing, but
I just want you to know I did record this shit through pink eye.
Just affecting everybody.
I can talk for fucking years, legitimate years. This is an outro to an album. You see how long I talk on the outros of songs, but goddamn. Look, I need to get out of here. I'm about to go take a Khalifa. Rest up. That's right, I did invent that phrase just there. Take a Khalifa. You know what I'm saying? I also invented that's what she said, but I get no credit for it. Shout out to dickheads, obviously. Funding this whole operation. What you know about a Kickstarter, man? What you know about the best fans in the world? Seriously. Thank you, guys. I appreciate it. Honestly, you made my dreams come true, and that's fact. Couldn't have done this without y'all. I'd like to shout out my dick. I know, you know, we haven't had the smoothest relationship, but I feel as though by kind of putting our issues out there, like, we have become something bigger than we could have been otherwise. And hopefully soon you will be rewarded for your patience. I will be rewarded for my patience. And I respect you. I'd like to shout out my brain. My brain got the hardest verse on the whole goddamn album.
Hey.
I hope my brain starts getting some
feature looks.
But he don't just hop on shit. Fuck, I got nothing left. I'm out. I'm a professional rapper. Long live LD. And in case I don't see ya, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.
Aww. So that right there was pretty crazy. When I seen that it said full version, I was thinking it was going to be a longer song. Not that dude was going to be talking for like the last 6 minutes. But it's a little Dicky, so it was definitely dope. I definitely thought this right here was definitely cool, from the outro to all the talking. But the song itself, we already know little Dicky, he's so multi-talented that he's able to literally jump on a beat and just switch it up. He's able to present funny songs. He's able to present, what I learned the other day after seeing Molly, like heartfelt songs. He's also able to produce just like raw, give it to you like you want it, like rah type rap music in your face, which I think is definitely dope. And then he's able to literally take all of those talents and combine them into one song, which is kind of what I felt like he did in this song. He was dropping knowledge, but at the same time in a humorous way. One of the parts in here that I really like what he said, basically saying like, I quit my day gig. You know what I mean? So to me, I think when people say that, it should kind of let other people know like how serious you are taking your craft or how serious you're taking this. Like, I can't stand when people continue to call my music or anything that I do a hobby. It's like, bruh, like this is how I get paid. This is how I eat. This is no longer a hobby. This is my career. Respect it. Respect it. No, but there's something else he also mentioned in here. Smalls. Hey, that nigga said shout out to my MacBook. My Mac Pro. Can you put the cap on that marker, please? Thank you. He said shout out to my MacBook Pro from back in the days. Well, in that case, I'm gonna go ahead and shout out Mixcraft. Yeah, that's where I started making my bedroom beats back in the days. So I've been doing this since like age 9, but I reinvented myself. I used to go as Nini from like 9 all the way up to like maybe like 18 or 19. And then I reinvented myself and I came up with the name Lyric Kane. And then I also, at that time, I was in between, like I wasn't really necessarily working with anybody. So I started, I took my first financial aid check, and y'all can look at me like, what? But yes. My first financial aid check that I received from school, and I bought books. Psych! I took my first financial aid check and I went and bought me a little studio setup. I bought me the microphone, the program, the computer, well, laptop, all of that little goody stuff. And yeah, boy, I started making my first mixtape, which I don't think I ever officially released. And then after, like, I think a year ago, I just wouldn't put it on SoundCloud, but it was called ADHD Self-Diagnosed. That was the name of my mixtape. And I produced that myself, got on there, and just really, like, went in on it. And I'm super duper proud of that. Like, bro, I think that's when it officially hit me that, like, this is what I wanted. Like, this is where I needed to be. Like, before that, I was young, so I was working with a lot of people. It was kind of, to me, it was, my hand was being held a lot through it. I wouldn't say I was being pressured to do it, but there was this teetering idea of like, yeah, do I want to go do shows or do I want to go to the basketball game and see the cuties? So it was kind of like in between. So once I felt like I did that, I felt like I needed to switch my name up just to kind of show that I was taking basically control of my career, what I say, what I sound like, what I look like, all of the above. Then I came up with the name Lyric Kane. Lyric Kane actually came from the fact that I personally enjoy writing. Writing is like one of my biggest pastimes ever. So I feel like the lyrics are the most important part of my song. Kane, it's a cheesy little saying to it, but you know, Lyric Kane, because my lyrics will leave you addicted, you know, like cocaine. Yeah, but there's actually this badass chick in this book. I'm a reader, in case you didn't know. It's called Little Ghetto Girls by Danielle Santiago. If you have not read that book, please go read that book. It's called Little Ghetto Girl by Danielle Santiago. And there was this chick in that book, the main character, her name was Kisa Kane. I just felt like she was so badass, so I stole Kane and I put it at the end of my name, and we just been on it since then. So shout out to mine. Thought that right there was pretty dope. Also in here, I like the fact that he kind of like mentioned the fact that he's a daydreamer. I feel like all creatives are daydreamers. Like, I swear, as a child, I could not understand. I spent most of my day like analyzing or playing my day out in my head. And half the time it never went that way, which kind of left me confused because I didn't plan for it not to go that way. But yes, that's definitely something I think that all creators do. Really enjoyed this track. I love Little Dicky. I feel like I'm definitely opening up more to him, not only as an artist, but as a person. Like, y'all don't understand, when I saw that Molly video yesterday, my heart cried. Like, no, don't you dare do that to him. Little Dicky's a great guy. So yeah, get in the comment section and let me know what else I should be checking out by my man LD. Also, go ahead and give this video a thumbs up, subscribe, and turn on notifications so that you don't miss out. And until next time, guys, peace out. I'm out of here.